So good morning to everyone. Today we will discuss a topic that is a consequence of autocorrelation. So previous class we discussed about what is meant by autocorrelation and what are the causes of
sir, autocorrelation. Voice
now it is not clear.
Clear.
Yes, sir, vastundi mi voice.
Now it is clear.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So today we will discuss that what are the consequences of autocorrelation. At the same time, after discussing the consequences of autocorrelation, we will discuss that Durbin-Watson test. That is how we can detect the autocorrelation. So whether the problem, whether the model is affected by autocorrelation problem or not, or so we will discuss that by using the Durbin-Watson test. There are other tests also there. We will discuss only this Durbin-Watson test. So tomorrow we will discuss other tests. Then here, what are the consequences of autocorrelation? What are the consequences of autocorrelation? Here, see, when there is a cause of autocorrelation, so when you are running a model, when you are getting a autocorrelation problem, so how it can affect on the model? How it can affect on the model? So that is called consequence of autocorrelation in a regression analysis. The first one is that when your disturbance term is serially correlated, then the least square, that is the OLS method or OLS estimation, are unbiased. See, when the disturbance term is serially correlated, then the OLS estimation is are unbiased. But optimistic property, that is the minimum variance, is not satisfied. For example, if you take into account when there are a serial correlation, serially correlated, then the OLS method is unbiased. But optimistic property, the minimum variance, is not satisfied in the model. So when you take into account both the unbiasedness and minimum variance, the unbiasedness and consistency, the minimum variance we can call as a consistency, do not depend on assumption there is a no autocorrelation. For example, if you take into account when you are estimating the unbiased and the consistency, so that that these two things cannot depend on the no autocorrelation, which is in this case violated. For example, if you take into account in the particular model, if the two things do not depend on the no autocorrelation, so in that case only it can be violated. Then second point, the OLS estimators will be inefficient. The OLS estimators will be inefficient. Therefore, no longer blue. For example, if you take into account when we are using a model, that is a regression model by using the OLS method. When we are getting a values of estimated y and estimated beta 1 or beta 2 or beta 3, etc., up to bn, up to beta n, the estimates will be inefficient. The estimates will be inefficient. Therefore, no longer blue. For example, whatever we will get some estimated values, that is a y cap or beta 1 a cap or beta 2 cap or beta 3 cap, etc., so that will be inefficient. Therefore, no longer blue, nothing but we cannot satisfy the blue property. That is called, we cannot get by some results may be not good and it is not linear. Sometimes it may be biased, and efficient estimator also we cannot get it. So that is the case. Then the third point, the estimated variance of regression coefficients will be biased and inconsistent. For example, as I told you that when we are estimating the coefficients of beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, that is the regression coefficients, the estimated variances of regression coefficients will be biased and inconsistent. Therefore, the hypothesis testing no longer valid. For example, when the variance of the regression coefficient is biased, so the hypothesis testing, that or testing of hypothesis, is not longer valid. Nothing but we cannot get the value, same value in the long term. It means that when the variances of a coefficient will be biased, nothing but whatever we are using OLS method, if its OLS method is biased or inconsistent, nothing but we cannot get minimum variance and expected beta is not equal to beta. So that is the case, the hypothesis testing is no longer valid. So in most cases, the R-square will be overestimated. For example, as I told you that when regression analysis we discuss, when R square will be overestimated. For example, sometimes R square value is equal to 1 or R square is near to 1. But when the independent variable may not affect on the dependent variable. So sometimes in the regression analysis, the R square will be overestimated. See, at the same time, for example, if there is an autocorrelation problem, sometimes we will get R square values high also. then we will see that, for example, if there is a autocorrelation problem, how much auto R square value, if it is higher or near to 1 or near to 0, then we will show in the, we will discuss after few minutes, then the t statistics will tend to be higher. For example, if you take into account, the t statistic will tend to be higher, nothing but the t value will be more. Then fourth point, if the disturbance term is are autocorrelated, then the wireless variance is greater than variance of estimate. For example, if you take into account that disturbance term, if the disturbance term is both are ET and ET minus 1 are correlated, that is called autocorrelation. So here, if the disturbance term is are autocorrelated, then the wireless variance, nothing but ordinal square variance, is greater than variance of estimate calculated by the method. Therefore, the usual T and F significance are no longer valid. For example, when we are calculating that, as we discussed, that coefficient or the estimated variance of the regression coefficients. So here, the variance is greater than the variance of estimates. So here, the T and F, the value, that is, we can say that it can be, we can test for the testing of hypothesis. So whatever we can do some testing, there is a t-test and f-test. So there, the significance are no longer valid. For example, we will get that significant, but the results may not be no longer valid. Then fifth point, the variance of random term may be seriously underestimated if the use are autocorrelated. See here, the variance of random error term, that is U, may be seriously underestimated. For example, if you take into account the variance of error term, so as we studied that heteroscedasticity, so when we are taking a random variable, that is the error term, the variance, how much the variance in the particular error term, so that may be underestimated. For sometimes we will explain that the variance of the error term may be minimum, but if it is higher, that is called, we can underestimate it. So if the autocorrelation, if yours are autocorrelated, sometimes, for example, before run the model, we can assume that there is no autocorrelation problem. So if there is no autocorrelation problem, we will get the variance of error term is minimum. When there is an autocorrelation problem existing in the model, generally we will get the variance of the error term will be high. So in that case only, if the variance of the error term is high, it seems that there is a autocorrelation problem in the particular model. Then sixth point, if the disturbance term are autocorrelated, then the wireless estimates are not asymptotic. Here, see, when the error terms are autocorrelated, generally when there is a correlation between error terms only, that is called autocorrelated. If there is a correlation between error terms, the wireless estimates are not asymptotic. Nothing but here, see, when you plot a random, we can say that there is a probability, there is a bell-shaped curve that is called normal distribution. Say when you plot the normal, when you take into account the values of error terms, when you plot a normal distribution table, it may be if left side are skewed or right side, so there is a positive skewed and negative skewed. In that case, the estimate like that, the estimators are not asymptotic. I think, but it can be not asymptotic. Then seventh point, there is a overestimation of rho square. There is a not p here. There is a rho square. It is called rho, RHO. See, when we are estimating that coefficient of error term, that square may be overestimated. For example, if you take into account the, as we written that equation, that is the autocorrelation, et is equal rho et minus 1 plus vt. Here the present year error term is depends on the its previous year error term and plus random variable, that is a random variable, that is called vt. So when we are estimating the rho value, that is a coefficient of error term, if it is, when we are square it, that square value may be overestimation. So these are the consequences of autocorrelation in the regression analysis. Then major part we need to enter, that is how we can detect the autocorrelation problem. Nothing but how we can understand the autocorrelation problem in the particular model, how we can easily understand. So there are two ways in general, that is informal and formal. That is, the first one is a for informal, second one is a formal. So how we can find out whether the particular model is getting a autocorrelation problem? First one is a informal method, that is graphical method or graph method. So in the graph method, how we can find out the autocorrelation problem? See, the first is a informal way, which is done through the graphs. Nothing but we need to calculate the residuals in the sense error terms. So we need to find out the already in the particular model, they will give the y values. Then we need to estimate the y cap values, that is the estimated equations. So after getting that estimated equation, we will get error. Nothing but how much the actual value is there. When you estimate in something, how much we will get error. For example, if you take into account, my class time is 11 o'clock, for example, that is my actual time. For example, if I am taking to account, if I have taken class at 11:05, it means that actual time is 11 o'clock. If I take into account, the estimated is 11:15. The error is 5 minutes. For example, if you take into account, so I expected that if you will join at 10 o'clock. For example, if you come to classes, so it may be 10 o'clock. For example, if you came to class at 10:05, I estimated that, so you are going to come by 10 o'clock, but you came 10:05. It means that my actual value, my estimated value is 10, you came 10:05. It means there is a gap between the estimated value and actual value. Estimated value is 10, the actual value is you arrive time, that is a 10 o'clock or 10:05, nothing but 10:05. So here the error is 5 minutes, like that. So we will estimate the residuals through graphs. Therefore, it will be we will call it graphical method. So then I will show you how we can do the graphical method also. Then the second way to detect the autocorrelation is formal test. So here, see, the second is through a formal test for autocorrelation. So there are tests. So it is a statistical test. We can find out whether the problem is whether the model is affecting or problem is getting autocorrelation problem or not. So the first problem, the first test is Durbin-Watson test. That is called DW test. Remember, autocorrelation test is called Durbin-Watson test. So this type of questions will ask in the UGC NET, SET and other competitive PG and NET exam also. Then the third test is the Bruce Godfrey test. So here the third one is a Bruce Godfrey test. That is a BG test. So generally the Durbin-Watson test will be applicable to the small sample. When we have the large sample, thousands and more than 1,000 samples, generally we can use Bruce Godfrey test. Then there is other test also there, the runs test. Then fifth test is Durbin's H test. Nothing but after developed the DW test, the Durbin and Watson, they have developed that Durbin's H test. The when we are using that laggard dependent variable, nothing but present error term is depends on its previous error. For example, as I discussed that the dependent variable is depends on its own laggard value, that is a presence of laggard dependent variable. Best example for the cost analysis, present cost is nothing but expenditure in present expenditure in the November is depends on the expenditure in the October and September. So in that case only we will use the Durbin H test. Then other test is Engel's arch test. So arch gauge test and term, this is a autoregressive test and term. Then we will discuss this test. Basically most of the people or researchers, they will use these two tests, the Durbin-Watson test and Bruce Godfrey test. So keep in mind, these tests also related to the autocorrelation test. then we will discuss that how we can direct the graphic method. So here, see graphic method, there are various ways of examining the errors. So simply we can plot them against the time. See here, so I have taken the data years, number of 31 years. So actual value is this much, 26.84. So I have taken the four independent variables. So after taking independent variables, after estimating the coefficients or after estimating the y cap, so I got that is a predicted value, that is the estimated y value. Here actual value and estimated. So when in order to find out the error, that is error is equal to e is equal to y minus y cap, y minus y cap. So generally y is nothing but that is the actual value, y cap is nothing but estimated or predicted value. So 26.84 minus 26.93. So you will get minus 0.092, like this. So same thing for the observation, that is called, I have taken the time series data. So up to 31 years, I have taken actual value and residuals, estimated values. Then I got residuals, nothing but errors. So after taking the errors, so simple, we can plot the graph against the time. This is the observation is called time. 1 year, second year, third year, fourth year. Like this, see here, the autocorrelogram, it is also called autocorrelogram. Sometimes they will call autocorrelogram. That is called, we can represent graphical autocorrelation. Nothing but autocorrelation we can represent in the form of graph method. That is called autocorrelogram. See here, zero. That is called, when you are getting error is zero, it is seems to be here. If you get the minus value, the points, the dots will be the down. If you get the error value is positive, you will get these points. For example, if you take this is a minus first one, so you are going to get here minus. The second one is a positive 0.09, you will get here. Then third one is positive, fourth one is positive, like this. The eighth one is negative here. So when you plot the diagram like this, this is called residual plots. There is x one variable, nothing but here. I have taken the time here. This is the time. Okay. So don't confuse that. So here the error values, these are residuals values. So or else we will put graph like this also. See, residuals are errors. This is a zero, error value is zero. It is a positive errors, this is a negative errors. So here, first one, observation, nine. Second observation, positive. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. Eighth observation, negative. Then, so it is called autocorrelogram also. It is called autocorrelogram. So on the base of this graph, we can understand that there is a positive autocorrelation, nothing but there is an ups and down, ups and down. Okay. So the sum of errors is not equal to zero. Okay. So it seems that if you take this error term, it depends on this one. This error term is depends on this one. This error term is depends on this one. It is depends on this one. It is depends on this one. This error term is depends on this one. Like this. Okay. This is called positive autocorrelation. Then we will see that here the positive first order autocorrelation, there's a positive serial correlation. See, when the graph shows like this or this, like this, it's called positive serial correlation. Positive serial correlation. Simple, when you are writing examination also, you need to write like this, positive autocorrelation. So graph method, you need to draw a graph also. Then negative is, see, negative. Okay. Then, yeah, so these are the graphing method. Then we need to discuss that what are the formal tests in order to find out the autocorrelation. Then this is a Darby.